Want to start this day out saying Jesus is alive and risen. Jesus is alive and well. Oh, Jesus is alive and well. So tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. Now he's sitting with the Heavenly Father. He's there interceding for you and for me. So tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. When they put Jesus on that old rugged cross, the devil danced around with glee. He thought he could take all the children of God. He wanted to throw you in the fiery sea, but I got good news. On the third day, the stone was rolled away, and the angel said to Mary, go and tell that the Son of God is already risen. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive and well. I know Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. Now he's sitting with the Heavenly Father. He's there interceding for you and for me. So tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. We gotta go tell the kings and tell the presidents, men. Tell them while his coming is nigh, that they better get their houses in order. I know the Lord is gonna split the eastern sky. We've got to go tell the people. Gotta tell them while there's still time to tell that the Son of God, he's coming. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive and well. Oh, Jesus is alive and well. Oh, Jesus is alive and well. I tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. Now he's sitting with the Heavenly Father. He's interceding for you and for me. So tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and very well. Hey, Jesus is alive and well. Come on, say it. Jesus is alive. Say it out loud where you are. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me, Jesus is alive and well. Now he's sitting with the Heavenly Father. He's there interceding for you and for me. So tell everyone you see, tell them for me. Let's tell the world Jesus is the answer. And he's alive and well, alive and well.
Good morning. We're glad you could join us. It's time once again for this edition of A.M. Kevin, starring evangelist, composer, and gospel artist Kevin Shorey and the entire A.M. Kevin Club gang. And now, from the new A.M. Kevin studios located in beautiful Ashland City, Tennessee, reaching coast to coast and around the world with the message that Jesus is the answer for this world today, is your host, Kevin Shorey.
Good morning and welcome to the AM Kevin Club. Isn't it a great day to serve the Lord? Did you like that song? Come on. Ba-bow. Oh, it's a great day to serve Jesus. I love him. I love him. I love him. And he is risen. He's alive and he is well. The devil's alive, but he ain't well. Jesus is alive and well. I love that line. Like I say that all the time. Psalm 61, hear my cry, O God, listen to my prayer. The Psalm of David says in verse 2, from the end of the earth I will call to you when my heart is faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For you have been a refuge for me, a tower of strength before the enemy. Let me dwell in your tent forever, and let me take refuge in the shelter of your wings. That's a good word for this day and age, right? It says Selah, which means pause and ponder and reflect and remember. We can take refuge in the shelter of his wings. You've heard my vows, O God. You've given the inheritance of those who fear your name.
You've given us that inheritance. May you add days, woo, to the King's days. May his years span many generations, adding to our days years. Come on. May he be enthroned before God forever. Appoint mercy and truth to protect the kings and the leaders. And I will sing, and to all of us. So I will sing praise to your name forever and fulfill my vows day after day. That is the word for us today. Good morning to all of you. Who is in the house? Who made it in first? Is California in first? Lyle. I got Lyle in first. Lyle and Karen, California's in there. And yeah, Londa, who produced that song that you just heard, that arrangement of Jesus is Alive and Well. There's Londa out there in Minnesota. Larry, good morning. And Phyllis in Arizona. And Sherry in Idaho. And let's see, Amanda. Amanda. Lacey E. Carson. There's two names there. Where are you watching from today? Cliff and Joyce are out there in St. Louis. And sounded good, looking good. Oh, thank you, Phyllis, as I'm looking good. Sandy in Texas, and let's see. Everybody's talking to each other. Londa loves it. I love you back and more. And Cindy in California. Bob and Fritzy and Larry and Jenna and Twyla and Ken. I'm glad all y'all are there. And Dave Hale out there in Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain. Talk about wind sweeping. Boy, the tornadoes and the storms went through. I thought there was some cool stuff. Let's start with some good news first. And you know, other than the fact that the governors are uniting and getting plans together, I like that when the nation is united, even though one has spoken out against president who said that, you know, I'm going to call it when I can call it, then they're all working together. And, you know, sometimes the president, a lot of times, the president sounds like, you know, he's a lone ranger and he does it all and he's the best and he, you know, he likes to toot his own horn. His last name is Trump. Hello. And so now the governor from New York, Cuomo, is saying, you know, he's not the king and he's not. I'm like, okay, just stop. I don't think he thinks he's a king. He might. I don't know. But I do know that when everybody works together, and I'm sure the president's going to work together with all of them, and no matter what the president calls, the governors do have the last say. So, you know, he knows that. He's not silly. But with all the storms that blew through Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, Texas, I saw some great things happen, some God moments maybe. You've got the Dora, Alabama, in near a church. They had three crosses, maybe in time for Easter. I don't know if they have it there all the time. But with the crosses, two of the crosses blew down. Guess which one did not? After the storm ripped through Dora, Alabama, this church's middle cross, the cross which was the symbol of where Jesus would have hung, left standing while the other two blew away. Interesting, huh? Another interesting thing. Laurel, Mississippi. Have you seen this picture? Look at this one. You look it up. In Laurel, Mississippi, as the tornado blew through, a house's roof and most of all the walls blew off, except for the kitchen. The roof is gone, and look at the picture. You'll see in the cabinet the dishes are in place, and a pound cake is sitting on the kitchen counter. The pound cake did not move. The roof ripped off, but the pound cake. Very, very crazy. And then many lives were spared. One girl saved, saying that she felt the hands of her father hold her down while the tornado ripped through their house and destroyed it. So, you know, in those tough, bad times, you know, there's over 30 that have been killed. There is some good news. And the rain falls on the just and the unjust. But God has a perfect plan and a perfect way in all things. He even saw the fact that Bernie would endorse Biden. Interesting, isn't it, that Bernie... But here's what Bernie said that really cracked me up. All of the United States rally together and get behind Joe Biden. That makes sense. But then he called on independents and Republicans even get behind Joe Biden. Okay. Thank you, Bernie. He has a big wish list, that's for sure. But with all of the things that are happening, you know, we really... And what, you know, my weasels list today, the press. Would the press and the reporters, especially ones at the press conference, see, they go, they're there every day. And they don't like it. You can hear the liberal media saying, you know, in the fake news, saying how we don't need these press conferences and we don't need to be doing this. Because it reveals that all they want to do is get these gotcha questions to the president all the time. When we really need, he's at those press conferences to give us information for our nation from the different doctors and the different ones on what we're supposed to do and where we're at in the nation right now, day by day. And they just throw the, could you have done better? Would you have done this? Well, of course, everybody could do better, but we're human. But, you know, what if you'd have done this? And are you really doing this? And then they would, they don't just say, what if, or could you have done, or did you? They say, you did this. What do you think of? And it's like, I didn't do that a lot of times. And it's like, they're out of supplies. There's no ventilators. No, that's not right. Of course there's, but there's no masks. There's masks. I mean, you can always get more things, be prepared, you know, all that, but it's these gotcha, right? Am I the only one that's just crazy? Charlene Shirley, good morning. Charlene Shirley, I like that. Dan is in the house. I love you, brother. Lyle, Lyle's back in. He must have went out and come back in. It's okay, as long as you come in. That's right. And Sad, I love that show. Did I mention a show? What show? I don't know. I don't know what Miss Kimberly was talking about. Hey, Kenny Day. Hello, Elizabeth. Hopefully we're praying for Elizabeth. Y'all put Elizabeth on your good. Hey, good to see you, Scott. Miss you, brother. God bless you. But Elizabeth out there in Northern Ireland, she has been suffering in health. And so we want to pray and believe for strength. She's going to be delivered and completely healed. Elizabeth, we love you. You've joined our AM Kevin Club. Join us and watch us all the time. And so you're part of us and part of family. And so we want to pray with you and believe for healing. David, good morning. And Michael, good to see you back in, my brother Michael. And everybody, you know, what is the deal, though, with all that? Really, do we have time for that? With all that's going on, there's two things. Time for unity, and there's time for just questions to find out what's going on in this world, not you should have done this, whatever did this, you know. We do need to pray for our nation. Pray for our president. Pray for our leaders. Pray for the media, you know. Pray for elections. Pray for our churches. It just saddened me. Another deal. I'm telling you, I'm going to get closer because I want you to look me in the eyes. I'm telling you, churches, pastors, I don't know if you know other pastors, other, you know, I understand faith, but faith is not equal to stupidity. And now a pastor in Richmond, Virginia, maybe well-meaning, but you got to understand, you're leading people into a hotbed of virus, and you're congregating it together. He says, I want to have church, you know, till they have to drag me away. Well, they had to drag him away. This pastor has passed away while holding, not while holding the service, but because of holding the services, got the coronavirus. This pastor now is dead. What good is his ministry now here on earth? I mean, he's happy in heaven. You know, his daughter now is saying, you know, his family is wrecked by all this. The church congregation, I'm sure, is urging people, stay home. Stay home. The daughter, you know. And, you know, I've been saying it from the very beginning. Faith is not stupidity. And it's still faith if you're safe and secure and going by the guidelines. And our government, with all of its faults, and the police and the military are not trying to shut down the gospel of Jesus Christ and shut down the church. It's to save people's lives. And there's just a difference. And when you go out like this pastor did and others have done, it's the same to me as those, and I'm about to use names, and I don't like calling people names. Use the same people who pick up the snakes in the church in the different parts of the country and tempt God. And it's just really, really ridiculous. Jerry, good morning and welcome to AM Kevin. Love you, Miss Elizabeth. We are going to continue to pray. Linda, my goat lady's in the house. It's always good, never bad, to see you in the house. Barbara, good morning. Tom, good morning. Welcome to the AM Kevin Club. Let us just get a grip on wisdom, discernment. You know, these are gifts of the Spirit that were given to us to bless others through those ministries, but also to help us personally to have those. And I really believe we need to pray for that now more than ever. Food, as you see over there, I do have some emergency food kits that I have stored. Our site, beprepared.com/AM Kevin, is closed. They're overrun with making the food. I believe that food can still be gotten, but not at beprepared.com. It is gone. It's now defunct. It is out of business. It is gone. There is other ways, and we're looking into that. But I do have a half a dozen left if you would like to have some food storage. It also includes 80 gallons of filtered water for you and those different things, protein and carbs to keep you healthy. And it's their survival in a pail. That's the 2 weeks. Down below are the 30 days. You can get one or the other, and I'm knocking $50 off each one. But this, we never charge shipping, but for these we have to. They're really, really, the shipping is not high, but more than we could put in our budget, or there would be no donation to our ministry. So take action. You see my action sign fell down behind me, so I put it there next to it. And call us. There's a phone right below. See, take action. Pick up the phone. Hopefully you don't have that kind of phone anymore. Don't sit. See, it's by a chair. Don't just sit around. Take some action and be prepared. James, Adam, good morning. Let's see. Yes, everybody. Church, as we have known in the past, is over. Church has changed. Yes, church will never be the same. And should it be, though? Should it always be reinventing itself? Should it always be not itself, but being led by the Spirit into the new? I've talked about that many times before, about how the church should be ahead of the curve, not behind. But we won't go into that sermon today. Take action. Be prepared. There's not only that, there's different things that you can cook with in the fire and the things in case your electricity goes out. It's something to be prepared in case of any kind of emergency. Any kind of emergency in a bucket. You can call us at 884-447-KEVIN. You can write us at P.O. Box 222 Pleasant View, Tennessee 37146. That's P.O. Box 222 Pleasant View, Tennessee 37146. Or go to kevinshorey.com and just ask for it. If you ask for it, we will help you out, because our website does not have all of our products or everything that we offer. We change daily. We can't keep up. So we want to, we could if I had a little bit more staff like I used to have, but we don't. So it's just me and Jesus, and we're able, and we're gonna do it. But in the meantime, all of you do, and then the specials change. By the time I get it up there, then I'm offering something different, and you know it's not the same anymore. So you know, just help us out. Go to kevinshorey.com, and Larry's putting it all up there. There is the P.O. box, and he's gonna put up Kevin Shorey, so you know how to spell Shorey, Shorey. .com. It is there, and Kim. Lou, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. And Rusty and Kara have joined. What state are y'all watching from? Like, for instance, I have one of my favorite. This is great. This is like Easter every day, because it's about the love of God, why he died and rose again for us. And it is, I've given God a million reasons not to love me. None of them change his mind. My favorite witness wear. It's our Million Reasons t-shirt. It's this beautiful gray, like Heather Ray, but this soft. Oh. With the red and the white, there's the white, there's the red. I've given God a million reasons not to love me. None of them change his mind. And I have put on, I've told artists for, since I seen the shirt, it should be a song. I just didn't feel at liberty to write it. And Larry Wilson, one of our guests, did. I will send you the song as a bonus if you get the shirt. Go to kevinshorey.com and ask for the Million Reasons shirt. Kevin, good morning and welcome from one Kev to another. That's right. And Brother Roger, we've been praying for him. The guy, he got a stent in his heart. His blood is flowing again. Praise God. Brother Roger, complete health, divine health and goodness for you. And every day we pray for you and your wife. So y'all have Roger on your list, Elizabeth on your list, our friend James Payne, who has the virus. And today, as a matter of fact, as soon as the program's over, I'm going to find out the test results. But we've been praying for my evangelist friend Michael French and his wife who came down with the virus. And I talked with him last night. It's tough. But he feels he's on the other side, and the test will confirm it. Hopefully, come back negative. It's the first time, he says, I've ever prayed for a negative result. Ha! I said, but your wife's getting tested too. And if she's negative and you're negative, two negatives make a positive when it comes to... Anyway, Charlene says, hopefully after this crisis, people will appreciate the opportunity to attend church more. I can't go. I'm loving online church. Online church is great, but going to church is great. And you know, here's what people miss it, because the church is not the building. It's not the people congregating together. You know, there were times in the early church they couldn't all get together. They had to just, as families, stay home and pray, hide out in caves. I mean, there were some real times of persecution and different times. Well, you know, we're not at the time of persecution, but we are at a time when we just have to, you know, when a door is closed, a window opens, or, you know, or another door opens. And so that's just where we need to go. And we need to think that the church is the people, not the building. So, you know, we need to pray for our nation. And people are really, there's a rapid rise in missing mortgage payments. And so we really need to pray, you know, folks don't lose their homes. You know, folks are losing their jobs. Unemployment, the unemployment office, you know, they're not taking phone calls. I have friends, relatives that saying that they can't get through. I mean, it's, you know, we need a miracle and we need to pray and not focus on these petty things like if we're meeting in a building or not. Just saying. Wendell, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. And I did look into some Dr. Fauci things since yesterday, and I think most of you are back on again. You didn't get mad at me for not knowing. But I was really shocked when Phyllis was calling him creepy or whatever she said. But not to call you up, Miss Phyllis, I love you. But so I looked in it, you know, and he can be creepy. There's some things that look like New World Order that look like... Now, first of all, I believe there are conspiracies and there are things... I believe there may have been an Illuminati, but they're not in power now. If they are, you know, what are they doing, really, if there is an Illuminati? So don't get me on the Illuminati stuff. And, you know, I'm not the hugest Tom Horn fan either. I love Tom Horn as a person, but if you know what I'm talking about, he writes books about the Catholic Church. He writes things about. And so even if Dr. Fauci, here's where I'm going to come from, and then I'm going to move on. Dee Dee, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. How are you and Ronnie holding up? And Steve, how are you doing, my brother? Hope you are well and healthy. I pray for you very frequently. Even if Dr. Fauci is part of the unholy trinity, if he works with the Antichrist, if he is the Antichrist, things like this cause me to pray and cause me to get more excited because Jesus is coming soon. If he is part of a new world order, if he's part of the mark of the beast, if he is part of anything to do with those things, it means come quickly, Lord Jesus. And I don't really report some of those kind of things, conspiracies. I like to know some things about it. I know you do too. But if we focus on more of the negative part, then that's where we'll go. I see it as a positive. Jesus is coming soon. And so, but I do value your opinions. And I didn't know anything. I didn't really do research on deep on Dr. Fauci and his background. But I do believe at this point he is trying to help a lot of people. Dr. Birx, I really love her. She's not creepy at all. But you got to admit, there are times when even President Trump seems a little creepy. Just saying, but I honor and respect him. Gloria, good morning. And then Bill Gates, right? Bill Gates could be part of the Antichrist system. You know, but see, the deal is, you take people at the face value for what they are now. You know, you investigate, you find out those things. But when it comes to end times, Antichrist, mark of the beast, all those things. Study to show yourself approved. Know the book of Revelation, you know, as much as you can. Understand end times and prophecies. Awesome. But don't let them petrify. Don't let them bring fear. And don't let them even bring hatefulness towards people, because we should be praying for Bill Gates, Dr. Fauci, praying for the president. And so that's where I'm coming from as I was thinking and praying about what I would say today, because I was just blown away at everybody's negativity. I didn't know anything about Dr. Fauci. So what I did see seems a little suspect, but we'll see in the meantime if it is meant for negative and it's going to turn things to an Antichrist system or mark of the beast. Hallelujah. Jesus is coming soon. Karen, good morning and welcome to AM Kevin. A tornado came through a mile from our house yesterday morning, but they didn't have any damage. Thank you, Lord, for protection. Good morning, Miss Carmen. I wish Cindy was on to say hi to you, too. I meant to tell her I saw you on the other day, and I will tell her today. Hopefully, she'll pop on. I don't know. Gaza Strip has not changed hands. Yeah, as far as in the view of prophecy, we understand. But yesterday, I mean, people were coming off like Dr. Fauci was, you know, part of the mark of the beast. And like I said, he could be. But anyway, I got my hero. These are my heroes, just ordinary people laying down their lives. I don't know if they're laying down their lives, but I thought I'm going to put on a hero. I've had some interesting heroes lately. You know, Andrea Bocelli, who did the thing at Easter, all those that made those Easter movies, you know, from The Passion of the Christ to The Greatest Story Ever Told, The King of Kings. These are great, great Ben-Hur. I thought, you know who's doing a great service to help our kids in this time of quarantine? Sesame Street has always been there, right? Tell me how to get to Sesame Street. And I just wanted to give a shout out to Sesame Street and Big Bird. Big Bird, you know, the man that played Big Bird for so many years passed away a year or two ago. But there's a continuation, you know, some new character playing Big Bird. And Big Bird is getting on the television and telling folks, thanks, Miss Carmen, telling all those folks in Sesame Street, all the young kids about quarantine and the virus. And I think that is so cool and what a great idea. So they're on my hero list today. And so many heroes are coming forth, from military to police to all the doctors and nurses, the healthcare workers, nursing home and rest home workers. Oh, God bless them. Just the clerks in the grocery stores and those that are on the front lines, really, just to help us. Farmers are still trying to produce, and all the different companies, those that are coming through, you know, from My Pillow Guy, the ones that are even donating towards, and even Bill Gates, who threw in $1 million towards, you know, research and Dolly Parton, who put in, and Lady Gaga, who raised money with all the millions to help research and for victims as well. And when the government doesn't help, I believe the church stands up. And so all those pastors that are actually doing the wise thing and are ministering to people through the, whether it's the drive-up, drive-in churches outside or the online churches, and they're doing everything they can, God bless them. And those, there are rescue missions and churches that are still feeding people and helping people. God bless them. They really, really, really need it. In a day when we've been, you know, ripped off from the devil and ripped off from really, you know, life right now and all these things, thank God there are heroes that are showing up. And I just salute to the heroes. And salute to Sesame Street and Big Bird today. I know. I'm weird. I mean, you know I'm weird. That's why you hang out with me. Because chances are, you're weird too. We're supposed to be a peculiar people, right? First Peter. You know, we're being ripped off. And I was thinking of, I saw some jokes about burglars. You ever been burglarized? Hey, how about a reminiscing with, this is cool. I had a sign. So we get to know one another. We've talked about, well, we talked about what's our favorite, everything from storms we've been through to famous people we have met to our best and worst diets and first kiss and even the brand of toilet paper you use. That's really getting personal, isn't it? But I found it interesting. People are still the Charmin people, even though I'm an Angel Soft guy. But there were a few of you Angel Soft people. Anyhow, have you ever been burglarized? Ever your car broke in, your house broke into, any things that have been kind of scary? And you know, when I was ripped off, and a couple different times, not a lot in my life, but one time in California, my car was broken into, and I had left my wallet in the car overnight for some reason. So everything was gone, including, you know, pictures that I had in it that were family pictures and, you know, treasures in there, but credit cards and money and all. You just feel like you just get violated in your life and that somebody's just in your personal space. And our house has never been ripped off before, but, you know, in my car alone, I couldn't imagine in the house. Good morning, Bruce. Bruce is one of my heroes, one of the greatest pianists, arrangers I know. I love Bruce. Played piano when I was a kid growing up in church and took invested in my life musically and put me out on a stage to do solos for my very first time in front of a very big church at the time. He was the pianist for the church, and I remember that youth choir and that ensemble so much. Bruce, God bless you. And he would be the pianist you would see, and I don't know if he still does. I'm not sure that Benny Hinn does a lot of crusades anymore, but that Bruce is Benny Hinn's pianist forever has been. My wife is there. Honey, do you see Carmen is in there? Carmen is here. Carmen Albert is in the house. Say hi to Carmen. She sent her love to us. Two cars broken into. Oh, Miss Sandy, so sorry. Here's a good one. We had a crummy pickup truck. It was parked in the curb in front of our house. This is Phyllis in Arizona. It was stolen and no one noticed for 3 days. Oh, Phyllis, that was a junky truck, huh? Tammy, Jerry, good morning, you guys. D, good morning out there in Blue Eye, Missouri. And so, you know, burglary or robbery is not that funny. Phyllis made it funny, though. That was pretty good. Famous people I sang with, Elvis. I sang with Elvis and before he'd at a funeral. Oh, I know. This is a great story. Pastor should be on the program just to tell this story about his Elvis story, his Elvis encounter. I cannot. You got to be on this story, on this show. Again. Brother, you have got to come through Nashville very, very soon. Soon as this stuff is over, for sure. Burger says to his accomplice, "The police are coming. Quick, jump. Get out the window," the accomplice says. "But we're on the 13th floor." He says, "This is not a time to be superstitious." That's how dumb burglars are, right? The other day, a guy pointed a gun at me and said, "Stick him up." And congratulations. I said, "What's the congratulations for?" He says, "You're just now entered a new lower tax bracket." Bank robber held up a bank. "Give me all your money." The teller said, "Here, take the books too. I'm short $10,000. And we're back. I knew my batteries were low to begin with, but I wanted to use up the all the suck out all the juice that I could before, you know. So we changed batteries at the same time. Did you hear that last joke? He says, go ahead and take the books too, or short 10,000 here in the bank. So one more. A burglar entered the house of a Quaker and proceeded to rob it. The Quaker heard noises, took his shotgun downstairs and found the burglar, and he aimed his gun gently at the burglar and says, friend, I mean thee no harm, but thou standest where I'm about to shooteth. Ha! Thought that was funny. Anybody laughing? No, I didn't mute you. No sound. I was changing the battery. Keith, good morning. Welcome to... Oh, there's groans. There's LOLs. This is when we need the Jeopardy song, right? You do. How about a game of Jeopardy and a little Bible trivia? How about that? Are you ready? We're going to play some Jeopardy. Oh, I can't do the song yet. Give me some decades. You want to pick some decades. 1940s, a question, a Jeopardy question from the 1940s, 1950s, 1960s, 1970s, 1980s, 1990s. Anywhere from the 40s to the 90s. Pick one and let's play the game. We're giving away prizes on Friday, so you want to make sure you want to watch on Friday. Thursday, Rick Allen King, our friend, he's been doing some blogs of music from his house, and they're really cool. And I said, come and talk about it. Well, you can't come. Call on the phone. So Rick Allen King's going to be here by phone tomorrow. Patty, we missed you. How you doing, Missouri Patty? Good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. Pick a decade. Let's go. And I got some Bible trivia question, too. Let's see. Also, health. Need somebody health. Not just anybody health from the AM Kevin Club. Johnny's in the house. I didn't see you come in, John. John's in the 1980s. So we got the 80s. Let's pick another decade. John's got the John out there in Texas. How are you doing? John's got like 25 kids. And so I can't imagine them sequestered, quarantined in that house. I can imagine. They're a great family. They had a nice big house. Beautiful. 50s, when you were growing up. So we got the 80s and the 50s. All right. We're going to put in the 80s and the 50s. So, Johnny, I hope you're staying sane. I know you are. You got the best kids. I don't even know what I'm talking. I'm just rambling. Hey, but I do love you all. And by the way, you that are family of friends, monthly partners, thank you so much. I hope you're enjoying, and you'll hope you will not only read this, encourage you, and build up your faith in the Lord, but will also be something that you will share with others. Evidence for the resurrection. This is my Easter gift to all my family friends at $37 a month. And it's 37 rhymes with Kevin. No, I've been in ministry 37 years. Isn't that amazing? It's awesome. But here's the skeptics' objections, their questions, and answers. There's seven in here in the evidence for the resurrection. Was Jesus a real person? Is there evidence that he rose from the dead? Can we trust the witnesses that talk about it? Could there be another explanation? You know, did somebody steal his body from the grave or what? You know, and it's all in it. This is put together so well. I couldn't wait to give it to you. Karen's enjoying hers. Good, good, good. And if you're not a monthly partner, sign up today, because I send you gifts every month. Please do it today. Our family of friends, we want you to be a part today. Our AM Kevin Club is, you can give at a lower level, but just be a part of the club, be a part of the partnership, be a part of the growing ministry. Yeah, even in this time of the old COVID-19, we are growing. God is blessing. Rosemary, good morning. You and Doug, God bless you. And yes, there is the address if you would like to join or sign up at kevinshorey.com. It's a secure site. You can give your debit or credit card, and you can do put in that you'd like to do it monthly. And if you do it monthly, we'll send you gifts every month. All right, we got a question you can answer. We're going to give away prizes on Friday. But today, let's go. Let's start with the 50s, 1950s, back in the 50s. Hey, Jules, you can play too. The Arco volumes. I love the Arco. I read that when I was a teenager. Patty, it's pretty something. Sandra, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. And Julie, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. Arizona and Illinois are in the house. Yay. Back in the 1950s, almost every living room had at least one. Bum, 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 bum. Remember, answer with a question. Bum, 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 bum. Ba da 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 da, and you'd only guess once. Da 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 da. Bum, bum 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 bum. Back in the 1950s, almost every living room had at least one. Nope, it was not a TV. Nope, it was not a radio. By the way, Patty, you didn't answer with a question anyway. So, what are tables? I'm sure everybody had tables. No, this is something I don't even know what it is. I've never heard of it before. I don't think I know what it is. It is not the television. Everyone in the 50s did not have a television. I believe most everybody had a radio, but it says almost every living room had at least one of these. 1950s. Nope, telephone. It's supposed to say, what is a telephone? That's how you do. What is a TV? What is a television? Nope. What is a radio? Nope. Nope. I don't know what this is. Patty, you're okay. Hey, by the way, while you're trying to figure this out, my health segment was about elderberry, and this store here has some. If you don't know how to get a hold of elderberry syrup, you should. It's really, really good. And now research has found it contains these phytonutrients. They're calling them phytonutrients and high antioxidant activity in your body if you take elderberry juice or syrup regularly, not just when you feel something coming on, because it does prevent and relieve symptoms of cold and flu. Not everybody agrees, but a lot of scientific research has found that it can prevent and relieve symptoms of cold and flu. I'm not saying coronavirus. I wouldn't do that. But this is really good God-made stuff with high antioxidants and builds up your immune system. Does it really help? According to experts, their most consensus you could find on it has great potential. So I thought on my health segment, get some elderberry. If you don't know how to get any, I can place some in your hands. I can make a deal with Joanne. We can get you some elderberry. It's some really, really good stuff made with some organic. She puts in some purified water, has organic elderberries, raw organic honey to sweeten it with organic ginger and cinnamon and cloves, cinnamon bark and cloves. Pretty cool. So check into elderberry syrup. What is a mirror, a phonograph, a Victoria? Nope. A Victrola, I think is what you mean. What is a mirror? What is a porta potty? What is a space heater? This was a record player. What is a fireplace? Nope. All right, this is it. It is, some of them had mirrors. Some were ornately carved and had different levels. I don't know what that means, but gramophone, no. It is what is, or what was, because I don't know if we still have them, what is a, not a rug, what is a leg lamp? No. What is a shadow box? Shadow box. Somebody tell me what in the world is a shadow box. I have no idea. I have no idea. Let's go to the 80s. John, one of the 80s. John, you better guess, and you better guess it. This was the largest wedding of 1986. The largest wedding of 1986. Go. Bum, bum, bum. Ba-da-da, da, da. Bum. Bum 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 bum. Ba da 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 da. Patty had one. Phyllis still has one. Dun dun dun. But I don't know what it is. A shadow box. Da da da. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum. John. Listen. In Jeopardy, you answer with a question. You can't just throw an answer out there. By the way, you're wrong. The Princess Di Prince Charles wedding was in 1982 or something like that, 81, 82, 83. This is 1986, the largest wedding of 1986. What is Arnold and Maria? See, that's how you answer. Sandra answered correctly. Oh, Charlene says a shadow box is a place to store knickknacks. Oh, okay. Rocky, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. My mom had one, says Cliff and Joyce. What is Princess Diane and Charles? Nope, it was earlier. 1986 was later, the largest wedding. The groom was in uniform, and the bride had a 17.5-foot silk train. 300 million people watched it, this wedding, on TV. 300 million. The population of the United States watched all around the world. Patricia, good morning. Welcome to AM Kevin. And we're almost done with our Jeopardy question. I want to give a Bible trivia one. So far, nobody's guessing. Nobody's winning. 1986. John thought he had 1986 trivia down. A shadow box hangs on a wall. Do people make the shadow boxes, or do you buy the shadow boxes? Elizabeth says, what it? See, from friend, now see, from the UK, Elizabeth would know. It is true. What was his bride's name, though, Miss Elizabeth? What is Prince Andrew is correct. It is not Princess Caroline. You were really, really close, Miss Sandra. And what is Prince Andrew? And what was Prince Andrew's bride name in 1986? I'll give you some time on that while I throw out a Bible question. What prophet says you can trust in the Lord and become strong if you soar high on eagle's wings, ride like the wind, and walk and not faint? What prophet prophesied that we can wait upon the Lord and rise up with wings, eagle's wings? What prophet was it? Patty in Montana got it. It is Fergie. This wedding, Prince Andrew and Sarah? No, not Sarah. I have two made by a friend of mother. Oh, two shadows. Next time we're at your house, Charlene, if we come through, you know, again, show me the shadow boxes. I'd like to see that. I'd like to see everybody's shadow boxes. There's Prince Andrew and Fergie. Who is Isaiah? Charlene got it. That's right. Isaiah chapter 40 is the one that said that. And that is true. All right. How about another Bible trivia? In Genesis, it talks about a bone was taken from Adam. And what bone was it? What was taken from Adam to make Eve? Come on. I'm trying to give easy ones to folks. Come on. That's right. But see who gets in first, really. Even John, you could get this. What kind of bone was taken from Adam to make Eve? And John got it. John did get it. What is a rib? John getting in first. Charlene came in first with Isaiah. I love it. And we'll do some more Bible trivia tomorrow. But I got a word. We're going to share a word. And I'm going to end with a song. Instead of our normal closing, I'm going to end with a song. I started out with Jesus is alive and well. And I'm going to go to end with a song. There were songs that we're going to sing yesterday for Easter, but I, not that yesterday was Easter, but you know what I'm saying. I wasn't here Sunday, so Monday, celebrate Easter. Judy, good morning. Judy Cable, love you, love you, love you. Proverbs 11 is where we're going to share today from our Devo. And I'm going to end with a song. And I was just wearing, you wonder why today, why are you wearing a hoodie, Florida Gators? I miss sports. I miss basketball. I miss just everything that's been sports. You know, we didn't have March Madness. Everything sports. There's no basketball. There's no nothing live. And so I was just, and it's cooler here. It's been in the 40s yesterday, today. So I put on a hoodie, and, you know, we have our hoodies. You can ask about those if you want to know more about our hoodies. We don't have Florida Gator hoodies, but I thought I'd put on my Florida Gators hoodie because I miss sports. That's the only reason. That was about it. Anyway, finally got one and lost audio. Oh, I'm sorry you lost audio. Because we're about to do the Devo. All right, Proverbs chapter 11. Word of God speak. Won't you pour down like a rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know you're in this place. Please let me stay and rest, Lord, in your holiness. Word of God, speak. In Proverbs 11, I've been staying there a lot in the past couple of weeks and sharing different words. Whoever wins souls is wise is in Proverbs 11. A person who does good will find favor and God will bless them and prosper them. And for righteous living, their rewards and righteousness exalts a nation and a city. And the righteousness and some of the unrighteousness, the unholiness, the blasphemy, and the even in these times where people don't turn to God, and as Isaiah prophesied, Isaiah 5, that good would be spoken of as evil, and evil would be spoken of as good, is flipped around. And the title of my message is: Have you ever got on the scales and say this scale must be broken, you know? Some days I feel like I feel skinnier than other days, and I'm going to really weigh good, and then the scale just keeps going up, and it's like, you know, or you get on the scale, and it says one at a time, please. Anyway, the scale's got to be broken. Well, I think the scales are broken around the world, and it's time for them to get back. What Jesus accomplished at the cross of Calvary and what he's done for us by rising from the dead, there's proof and evidence for the resurrection. And some will try to deny him as Lord and make him just another good man or some prophet. But to quote Peter, who says, no, you're the Christ, the Son of the living God. And you're our Savior, you're our Redeemer, you're our Healer. You're our Restorer, our soon coming King, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But the scales are broken in 11. One, which I always skip over, just hit me last night. Dishonest scales are an abomination to the Lord, to Adonai, but an accurate weight is his delight. The pride will come to disgrace, the humble will have wisdom. The integrity of the upright guides them, but the crookedness of the treacherous will destroy them. Riches make no profit in the days of wrath, right? You can have all the money in the world, it's not going to change this virus. But righteousness delivers from death. The righteousness of the blameless man walks his way straight, but the wicked man is brought down by his wickedness. The righteousness of the upright delivers them, but the treacherous are trapped by their desire. Dishonest scales, Proverbs 11:1, are an abomination. You see, in the times of the Old Testament, in these times, there, in each city, and near the temple even, there were chambers of measures. So I read from Rabbi Jonathan Kahn, where they determined the values, the weights, and the quantities of the sacrifices at the temple, but and also when you would bring your coins, or you know, their value was measured by the weight, and if you were crooked and you were not doing right, Jesus called this out at the temple. Good morning, Miss Heath. Good morning. Brother Alton, one of the greatest preachers I've ever known in my whole life, is Alton Garrison right there. I love him. One thing that upset Jesus and people who knew that they would alter the weights or use false measures and rip people off, you know, like making something cheap way more. They could do that for themselves, or things that were worth more, make them look cheap, saying that this, you know, this coin wasn't, or this weight is not this gold or this silver or whatever. And they tried to redefine, this is what hit me, redefine the measures or the weights to conform to their greed and their will. Does this sound familiar? It seems like in our nation and those who protest against Jesus, who buck up against righteousness, who, as in Isaiah 5 says, calling evil good and good evil. In that day, the corrupt merchant would redefine what was good and what was bad by changing the weights and the measures. And we have tried to change even the Bible and try. This is what we measure our life by and our weight by. And a corrupt communication will, a corrupt civilization will always define good as bad and bad as good, using their own meanings, their own definitions, their own truths, bent to fit their own will. man literally saying, I'm God and I know better. But when that happens, what God has set in order, there is a true weight. There is a true measure. There is absolute truth. Absolutely. And when we try to change it, chaos then proceeds. And the prophecy of Isaiah 5:20 becomes a reality. Evil is spoken of good and good is evil. Man saying, you know, I'm going to bend the truth to fit my lifestyle and my way. And, you know, I'm better, bigger, and better than God. Instead of us trying to conform and bend our lives in the way of God, the truth is God's word, and our desire should be to be in this word and be transformed by the renewing of our mind. How? By not being conformed into the world's image, but into his image every day. Let us be on the lookout today, and let us be aware of false measures and false standards and just out lies, half-truths, white, you know, because they always lead to destruction. The truth is, Jesus is real. Jesus is the answer. But he cannot be an answer if we don't really seek for the truth. We must seek for absolute truth. We must seek it in the Word of God and abide by the Word of God. All of us, every day. But we must also not only live it ourselves, but when people are astray or askew, just a hair, it only takes a little bit of poison to mess up a whole bottle of good water, right? A little bit of poison to just, you know, mess up your tea. All it takes, just a little bit. But we have a contaminated, false measuring, false weights, false values that is trying to overwhelm the reality and the absolute truth of Jesus. So, you know, let's stick to the truth of God's word. That's right, Charlene. And we can't go wrong. They say that Jesus is not real, that he's dead and gone, but we have evidence for the resurrection, right? We know that he's real. He's alive and well. Oh, the disciples now, they're past the, this is the day, you know, we commemorate Easter as the resurrection day on Sunday. This is 2 days past Easter. And you got to know that they're just telling people, he's alive, he's well. They can't wait to see him again. Peter, by now, has had breakfast at the beach with Jesus, and he says, I'm going to do whatever you call me to do. And their lives were changed, and then Jesus is about to talk to him and tell him, you know, I'm going away, but I'm sending you a comforter, and I want you to go meet in Jerusalem and get the power to become witnesses. All this stuff is now taking place. Jesus is alive. Let him be alive in your life. He is the answer. We'll be back tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed today's edition of AM Kevin Club. Pray for us every day. Pray about how you can help us monthly or with a one-time gift. I've given you some gifts we'd like to give you if you'll do that. But more than that, know that we're trying to let people know Jesus is the answer for our world today. And I will see you tomorrow. And go out with this song we recorded on our Heaven CD. And a great classic. One of the very first songs I ever sang as a kid in front of an audience. And I hope you enjoy it today. Go ahead. Drive the nails in my hands. He said, laugh at me. Stand, go ahead and say it isn't me, but the day will come, oh, and you will see, 'cause I'll rise again. Somebody promise. But very Hallelujah.